Hi, my name is Jason Kang. I'm a full-stack developer working in South Korea. Today, we're going to continue with our cloning medium series. We're going to clone this area right here and call it a header. I was debating which tag we should give it. Because of the nav and the site we created, it doesn't look completely like a header. But if you look at the definition of a header, it contains introductory content. So I thought it suits our purpose because if you click home, you can see that our main content. And if you click about, you can check the information about the author. And if you click list, you can see the articles that the author is interested in. So I thought it suits our purpose because it can work like a header. So name will be the header and the button right here will show more options. And we're gonna add a nav tag under the header as a parent of our a tags. So let's do this. First, we'll add some contents first and then add styles later on. So let's get this. Let's add our header and the button here and the contents information. So let's create the HTML tags first. And then we're gonna add a div tag for our as a parent. And we're gonna add a div tag to as a parent of our header and the button to use the flexbox. There we go, and then let's add nav tag as our parent of our a tags. There we go. And let's add class names to use styles. Except the header. Might as well, yeah, let's do that. And the class div header. And first, let's start with the font information. Oops, let's use CSS viewer instead. It's 42 pixels and line at 52 and 191919 with font weight 700. So. There we go. And header also has a default margin, which is why there's space between these two. So let's get rid of that. There we go. Let's get the margin information on our parent with the developer's tool. Oops, sorry about that. It's 52 from the top and 48 from the bottom. So let's get our parent. Margin is 52 from the top, 0 on horizontal, and 48 on the bottom. Like that. And then we'll add display flex. Flex direction row. Align items, center, justify content, space between, like that. And we'll make our header take up about 50% of the width, because if you take a look at this, this purple area means that it can expand to that area. So let's add the width to it. Oops, there we go. About 50%. There we go. And then we'll get rid of the style of this button right here. If you take a look, the size of this button or this image is 25 pixels each. So let's get that. Oops. There we go. Oh yeah, width 25. And transparent. There we go. And then to make it look like a button, we'll add a cursor pointer. So it looks clickable, right? Now let's get information about these three. So the font size is 14, line height 20, and 292929. So let's get that. There we have them, and they are also, let's see. Turn this off real quick. They are 32 pixels to the right and then 16 pixels from the bottom. So let's get that information as well. And then we're going to use our child selector again. Copy that. A not lost child. There we go. And then they have padding bottom toward, I think it was 16. Wasn't it? 16. And then the border color would be the same. Like that. And then if you take a look, the nav bar also has a border. And let's get that color, which would be same. And then that would be okay, let's magnify it real quick. Let's get the color. Can't, it's kind of hard to pick this color. Let's just take a look at our developer's tool. Border bottom. This is the color of the border bottom. Then we're going to add that to our nav. And that is because it does not have the padding. So let's get this. There we go. Well, they are not on top of each other. And then that means we'll have to fix that. Let's get rid of the border just real quick. So if you take a look at this website right here, the color is different because the one is active is black, but one is not active, the color is gray. And so let's add another class just for styling purposes and change the color of these two. Let's get that color information. Oops. The color is 757575. So let's call it a, oops, a header. Inactive, like that, and then we'll add a color. are the colors different. And you can see I've added two class names, but it took a color from the inactive class, not the one that we declared earlier. That is because if two styles crashes with each other, it takes up the style that's declared in a lower scale in the file. So if you take a look at this website, the original Medium site, if you click these, the color changes. And the click is called event. And in web development, everything about event handling is done by JavaScript. So this is where JavaScript comes in. So in the next session, I'll talk about event handling and how you can access those A tags with JavaScript so that only one that is active has different color from others. And that's it for today. So hopefully you're following this series as we continue on so that by the end of it, you'll have a blog of your own creation. And as always, if you want to learn something specific, please leave them in the comments below so I can answer your questions. Thank you and stay tuned.